the best 34 seconds of your life? Probably not. But if in 34 seconds a guy like this can detect something that might save your life, what are we talking about?
Well, what he doesn't know is that I had to lose 5 pounds in order to make my finger a little smaller. No!
He's here till Thursday. Try the veal. No, it's my turn, right?
But the bottom line is, you know,
yes,
you're probably...
Yes, Phoenix Patient's waiting
turn.
For you.
All right. Al, good luck. We'll see you in a couple
for
of minutes.
For the second opinion, we're going to use 2 fingers.
Yeah, okay. See if you can beat 34 seconds, Doc.
Oh, my goodness. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the voices you heard, Matt Lauer, Al Roker of the Today Show on NBC TV, and our friend... Dr. David Somaty, Chairman of Urology and Chief of Robotic Surgery at Lenox Hill Hospital. You watch him on the Fox News Channel on House Calls on Sundays. And Doc, congratulations. The whole world's talking about what you did on national television yesterday by, you know, not exactly fully exposed, but behind closed doors. Nonetheless, giving a prostate exam, a digital exam, as they call it, to Al Roker and Matt Lauer.
Yeah, this was a great opportunity to bring awareness to people out there. And certainly Matt has been my patient for the last 5 years. And it's a great message out there that in 34 seconds, we can find out exactly what's going on with someone's prostate and do the right thing. I thought bringing a little humor, and by the way, I had none of these lines ready. It was just a live TV.
I was going to bring up the ad libs. Yeah, go ahead.
So, you know, I thought it was, you know, making it a little humorous is a good idea because men are always scared of going to doctors. They don't like to be screened and get checked. And I thought it was a great segment, you know, and in conjunction with what we do on Fox News on Sunday House Calls, bringing tremendous amount of awareness to the world. So being that he asked me as my patient to do this, I was happy to bring it. And I think that the response from people out there was extremely positive, and they liked it.
Yeah, no, you added the right touch of humor, and if you could do that with all your patients, you certainly would make them all feel at ease. And I know your bedside manner is as warm and wonderful as you appear on the air, and that was evidence of it right there under pressure. But you handled it very well, and I think that was a wonderful thing to do because I don't think there's enough talk about it. You know, I'm all for the pink ribbons in the NFL and the pink bats in Major League Baseball and Breast Cancer Awareness Month, but I don't think we do enough to make everyone aware of prostate cancer. So kudos to you. Congratulations. Let me ask you about some other areas of concern here, Doctor. And two of them took place on the regarding football head coaches in the NFL. We had an incident where at halftime of a game, the coach of the Houston Texans, Gary Kubiak, collapsed, was taken to a hospital. It turned out he had a mini stroke. He felt dizzy. And the head coach of the Denver Broncos was playing golf. Apparently, he knew he needed some kind of heart surgery, was trying to put it off for until after the season, and was golfing with friends and felt, and collapsed. And he was rushed and had to have emergency surgery. So two guys who, you know, are lucky that what happened when it happened, on the golf course in front of people and on the football field in front of people, and not in a bathroom or in the middle of the night where they banged their head or something, God forbid, and no one found them.
Absolutely. And I think these are two different diseases that can happen in very young people. The first impression was, could stress from all these competition and sport do this? Dehydration could be part of the reason why they passed out. But very soon they found out in Kubiak, he has what we call a mini stroke.
TIA.
TIA, transient ischemic attack. And that really, simply put, for people who don't know what it is, it's almost like the way your light bulb is about to go out. And it starts by going out, coming in, and lights up, light and turns off. That's the sign that you're going to have a problem. And usually there's no loss of consciousness, but you may see somebody just get dizzy, etc. And the way to do this is to really find out what's going on in their carotid arteries, if there's any plaque or cholesterol that's causing the blood flow not to get to the brain and cause this kind of things.
What's the symptoms real quick if somebody is with somebody or somebody feels it themselves? What should they look for?
So, you know, the mnemonic is FAST. So it's basically facial drooping. It's the arms that one arm can stay and the other one will fall. And then slurry speech. And T is for time, which is you have to call 911 before someone have a massive stroke.
Right.
And the other disease with the coach Fox is basically a bowel problem, And sometimes patients can have leaky valve where the blood is not going to really get pumped out. You don't get enough blood to your system, and that's how they end up getting passed out. So the surgery is going to be fixed, and surgery is very effective in fixing some of these valves, and I'm glad we found out about it early.
Yeah, yeah. I tell you, Doc, I was so proud to see you there on the Today Show doing that. I think it was just wonderful. Let me tell you why I did it. We only got 40 seconds, but go ahead.
One of my patients by the name of Peter Latos, who was a Greek guy, he's 44-year-old. For the first time, a patient died. His PSA was 60 when he got to me. After 4 years of hard work, he passed away. And people need to know that even young men can die from prostate cancer. And that's why I did what I did that segment.
Wow.
And I hope it will bring awareness to people.
Wow, 60. We should point out normal is under 4. 60
exactly
is,
right.
is amazing.
Unfortunately, he came in too late.
Yeah.
So get a baseline at 40, not 50. That's a big mistake.
Yeah. Doc, great to see you. We'll speak to you next week. We'll watch you on Fox this Sunday. Dr. David Somaty, Chair of Urology and Chief of Robotic Surgery at Lenox Hill Hospital. When we come back, folks, we're going to be joined by Richard Pearl to talk about Iran on the Steve Malzberg Show.